In this video, I'll be going over the three states of matter and some important differences between all of them. So the three main states of matter are gas, liquid, and solid. Some of your classes may just go over these three, some may also talk about plasma, but the main three are gas, liquid, and solid. And so up here, I also have a little zoomed in picture. If you were looking at atoms or molecules of these three different states of matter, what they would look like. And so we can see our first difference is that we would consider gas molecules or atoms to be very far apart. There's really only a few in our picture of gas. And we'd consider liquid and solid both to be close together. So most substances are a little bit more dense in solid than in liquid. That's not true for every substance. Water is a big exception where liquid is more dense than solids. But in general, the gas molecules and atoms have tons of space in between them. And liquid and solid are pretty much right next to other liquid and solid molecules or atoms. So next, continuing to talk about how these states of matter relate to other atoms or molecules of their same type, gas molecules are not bonded to any other molecules. Each gas atom or gas molecule is completely by itself, just whizzing around, doesn't have to think about any other atoms or molecules of its type, whereas both liquid and solid are bonded to other liquid and other solid atoms or molecules. So depending on how in-depth your class goes, you may talk about particular intermolecular forces and what that means for liquids and solids, but in general, we'd say that liquids are loosely bonded to other molecules, whereas solids are tightly bonded to other molecules. Next, talking about movement, gas molecules and atoms are moving the fastest, liquids are in the middle, they're slower than gas, faster than solid, and solids are moving the slowest, and they're always moving, but they're vibrating in place usually. And so if we were to draw movement lines in our three depictions, gas would look something like this, liquid would look like this, and solid would look like this. So these movement lines indicate that each gas molecule or atom is whizzing around really fast on its own. Each liquid molecule or atom is moving around, but not as fast as gas. And all the solids, nothing on Earth is ever going to be completely still. It's even if it's very, very, very cold, it's still going to be vibrating in place. All of these atoms and molecules have energy, and some of that energy gets turned into movement. Next, we have how these three states of matter react to the containers that they're put in. And this is a classic test question that you'll be asked about how do these three states of matter react to different containers, and they all have a different response. So gas always fits the shape and the volume of a container. So we have this balloon here, and we would expect gas to be in this part of the balloon, and we expect it to be in this part of the balloon. We don't expect that there'd be some pocket over here of the balloon with no gas. We just kind of know that air or other gases fill whatever container they're in. So for instance, whatever room you're in right now, you wouldn't expect that if you stood on a table and put your head at the very top of the ceiling that you wouldn't be able to breathe. You would think, no, there's definitely oxygen and air up at the very top of the ceiling, and there's oxygen and air where I am. You just kind of instinctually know wherever gas is, whatever container it's in, it's going to spread out and be in all of. So liquid is in the middle. It fits the shape, but not the volume of the container. So we can see here, the entire container is this big. It's this glass, right? But there's only enough volume of the water to fill up halfway. If we had more volume, it would fill up more. If we had less, it wouldn't even get halfway. So liquid just has its own volume, and that's just going to be what it is. It's not like gas where it's going to expand and fit every single part of the container. So similarly, whatever room you're in, if water started to pour into that room, you'd expect it to only go on the ground. You wouldn't expect it to all of a sudden be in the entire room because it's not going to fit the volume of the container. But it will fit the shape, right? So you could have any shape of glass and you can pour water into it, and it's going to fill up whatever amount of volume it has in that glass. It doesn't have a set shape on its own. And so solids have a rigid shape, and they won't fill volume or shape of container. This is kind of a weird example because kiwis are kind of wet, but they're mostly solid. And so even though they're in this glass bowl, these kiwis have their own shape. They're just going to be there. They don't fill up the volume like a gas would, and they also don't fill the shape like a liquid in a gas would. They just are like, well, I have my own shape. I'm just going to be this shape. I have my own volume. I'm just going to be this volume. No matter what container you put me in, that's just who I am. All right, and so next, talking about flow. So gases flow very easily, and the particles can move past each other. So this gas molecule over here can just move past the other two. It's not bonded to them at all. It can just do whatever it wants to. And liquids flow easily, and particles can move past each other too. So this molecule right here, if it wanted to, it could go over here, it can move, it can go where it wants to. And solids, they do not flow, the particles are in place. For gas, if we had something that smelled really good, like a hot pizza, we put it in the corner of the room, all those pizza molecules are going to go into the air, they're going to flow past the other air molecules, and they're going to enter your nose. So gases can just flow past and do whatever they want to. And again, liquids, if we had a bathtub or a pool, and we dropped a little bit of food coloring in the corner, and then we left and came back, we would expect that that food coloring had spread out, because the food coloring liquid particles can move past each other, and they can move past the water molecules. So even though they're close together, they can still move past each other. And solids, they do not flow, the particles are in place. So if we have a molecule and it's on the left side of a table, and we leave the room and we come back, that one molecule is still going to be on the left side of the table. It hasn't now magically moved to the foot of the table or the right hand side. And that's because those molecules are tightly bonded to each other. They're unable to just pick up and move and go somewhere else. And the last thing we're going to go over is the compressibility of these three states of matter. So gases, we'd say, are easily compressible. What that means is that even with just the amount of force that any human would have, you can make a volume of a gas smaller than it used to be. I think the best example of this is thinking about syringes. If you just had air in a syringe and you plugged the hole and then used just the strength of your thumb to press down, you could make the syringe take up less space. You can compress that gas. And that's because there's so much air in between each individual gas molecule. So you can see that all of these different states of matter definitions really kind of stack on top of each other. Because they're very far apart, because they're not bonded to any other molecules, you're able to compress it. And liquids and solids, we'd say, are not easily compressible. And that's just because they're already close together. So you can compress them, but it's going to take a lot of strength, a lot more than a gas. And so because these molecules and atoms are already very tight together, they're already loosely or tightly bonded to other molecules, you're not going to be able to just compress it and make a liquid a lot smaller. So for instance, if you have a cup of water or a syringe of water, you can't just press down and make that liquid become smaller. And you can't do it for a solid either. Those volumes are going to be pretty much set. There's a little bit of wiggle room. You can force stuff to be smaller, but it's going to take some kind of machine or something that's not just a little bit of effort. All right, hope this video was useful. And as always, happy studying.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to subscribe, click around, and watch my other tutorials. And as always, happy studying.